it's Rosenthal, if it satisfies the condition we used it several times. What kind of condition? Go to the pointwise closure and check what kind of functions besides continuous functions you get. Okay? So if you still are, let me repeat again, if you still are in the area of continuous functions, what we have? W limit property and weak compact subset, just by Gordon-Dix result. Now we need to see what happens beyond continuity, what kind of properties we have. And for, I think it is very natural to try, first of all, doing it by bare classification. So we have continuity, bare one function, bare two function, and so on. So losing, you know, your paradise of continuous functions, the first question should be if you can at least get something like bare one. I say something, why? Because bare one, it is okay, it's for compact metrizable case, it's the same as fragmented. But my way to express the same is to ask this question. When you get your closure in bare one class of functions or fragmented victim functions. Again, for compact metrizable spaces, it's the same. And very fortunately, this class on this situation is well known for many experts because it was one of the central ideas is a work of Bourguin, Fremley, and Dalla. So here I put some, first of all, the source ideas, the basic ideas come from Rosenthal, but then you know the Bourguin, Fremley, and Dalla famous results, and part of these results you can find, for example, the book of Dalla. And just I use here some reformulation of their results given by Dalla. And according to this reformulation, it is easy to see the condition, the definition, or Dalla do not use term fragmentability, but he used term point of continuity property. But in our setting, when your original space is compact, it's exactly fragmentable. So it's just my reformulation of condition by Dalla, which actually comes from Bourguin, Fremley, and Dalla. So if you need now, if you understand now what is Rosenthal family, Rosenthal family is just a version of our tame function. So what was tame function in dynamical system? Oh, I should say it another direction. Tame function is a particular case of this Rosenthal family. So, in fact, I already mentioned even defining tame functions. And the idea, original idea, comes from the work of Bourguin, Fremley, and Dalla. So, this is a Rosenthal family, means that the closure, pointwise closure, remains in the area of fragmentable functions. Okay, see you. And this can be reformulated. Again, it is quite similar to the case of Asplund, not the same. A little bit, some more difficulties, but not so much. You can reformulate in this way that is eventually fragmented family of maps on B star, and this gives us some possibility to mimic situation we already faced in Asplund cases. Because in Asplund cases, if we can manage something, some fragmented family, now for eventually fragmented, many things become similar. That was one of the ideas. Haydon, we need it. If you remember, I explained the Haydon characterization of Rosenthal. dullness, and again it's here, if you remember what was what we show is using Hadron's characterization, just a dynamical point, dynamical difficulty, some continuity, some of actions, in order to see the two kinds of topologies are the same. In one case we are in a good position, we can check something in that effect, but in order to really check the second, we use the coincidence of this topology. And there is no possibility to see it avoiding Hadron's theorem. That is why we really need, I don't know any other proof avoiding Hadron's theorem. Just in Rosenthal case, I can avoid it for reflexivity, for example, and so on. Okay, let's go. Okay, so it's my short answer to your big question. Let's go to the corresponding classes of dynamical systems, back to dynamical systems. So what several times, even repeatedly, mentioned HNS. So HNS, as I already explained, is a kind of lack of butterfly effect, in short, okay, as intuitive, but also, so there is no dependence on initial conditions in other terminology, but we need to know some exact mathematical formulations, and even not necessarily for some metric or something like this. And we found with Eli Glasner this introduced this definition, because sensitivity was well known, but we found the sensitivity state is not so good to manage with this class, and we found that hereditary sensitivity is much useful, and it exactly captures the idea of Asprungness. I mean, this exactly are dynamical systems which live in Asprung-Banach spaces. So that was a critical point to convince ourselves, okay, we found this really good object to start. So the definition, there are several definitions equivalent. So first one, just again, use fragmentability. So first of all, are the same. Maybe you should try from second condition. What is the second condition? I already mentioned it, but again, it is not easy to remember all definitions. So take the all translations from our dynamics. And you have family of functions from x into x. And you have the corresponding data, x, your x is a topological space, and also uniform space. Why? Because compact space. Yeah. So whenever x is compact, say with some topology tau, and you consider some function, you can put here the unique unique uniformity compatible with topology tau, such that the topology of a new, it is very well known that for compact Hausdorff spaces you have only one uniformity. So in this sense the definition is very natural. So you can check if your family of translations are fragmented family or not. So if you check it, you immediately see that it should be translated what I see, what I wrote here on this first condition. First condition is slow motion, is just the second condition, but by definition. Okay? Okay? And the third, it is not so trivial but quite straightforward, that this definition is equivalent. Ah, okay, this just almost trivial. So, sorry. If you take now the enveloping semigroup, what's the enveloping semigroup again? That's pointwise closure of this one. So, pointwise closure, it preserves fragmentability, like equicontinuity is preserved by pointwise closure. You know, this, the similarity is a similar proof even by 3 epsilon argument. Okay, this is what? Yeah. Ah, okay. What this one is not so. I wanted to say that this one is not fourth, but you can treat it as a fourth condition. These conditions are equivalent to the following: that if you take any individual continuous function, then the corresponding FOS, corresponding orbit, as a family of functions, will be fragmented. So one direction is almost immediate because you push x to x, x to r, take composition, and in one direction it is easy. But the second direction is not so easy. That's why I said it's not so short. Now definition of tame. Tameness requires some similar idea, but of course it's different. It's much weaker. What is the definition, first of all? The definition, my choice here is to take the source, the first definition, in terms of enveloping semigroups. So, what's the definition? We say that our dynamical system is tame if any translation you get from your enveloping semigroup, or any map from an enveloping semigroup, is fragmented map. So, this immediate, so if you meet here, this one, this F, is fragmented, right? I mean from H and S. And in H and S, it is equivalent, if so, that E X is fragmented. Because your S tilde is here, and just this one is just pointwise closure by definition of enveloping semigroup. But now about tame. So first of all, maybe the best way to understand it: if our family, full family, is fragmented family, it is trivial that every individual member of this family will be fragmented, right? So that is why from HMS we have tameness. And what is tameness? We require now that every individual member from this family, every P from our index, again, it's a map from X into X. Okay, this time I'm going to try tau and mu. The same reason is fragmented. So if your family is actually fragmented, of course, obviously, any member will be fragmented. That is why the HNS implies 10. Okay. And what is the reformulation? Again, not so trivial and requires many steps. It is equivalent to say, but maybe expected after getting the idea of this definition. If you take Fs, the orbit, how small it is. If it is Fs, eventually fragmented, or it is equivalent, again not trivial, that it's free of independent subsurfaces. We already mentioned what is independent, that's just a classical definition which is one of the key ideas in the Rosenthal dichotomy. Now about some conclusions of the big theory. Okay? So, as expected now, after our definitions and after my explanations, What is the role of TAME and HMS? It's very similar to the role of Victor Gusperovic to related to reflexive. I mean, TAME systems and just TAME systems are the systems which are Rosendahl approximable. And analogously, HMS systems are just systems which are Asplund approximable. Again, for metrizable, by our general remark, for refractive approximable can be replaced by representative. It's good to take into account. 585, about back to our definition, our dynamical version of Eberlein, Radu-Nikodym, and Radu-Nikodym, we have the following criteria. And and this theorem is interesting even for topological case. If you take even a trivial action, a trivial semigroup, and formulate it just for compact spaces, at least the third result seems to be new, as to my knowledge. So what we have here, that that X is compact again, that formulated just for a topological case. So for a X is Eberlein, even only you can find F, which is okay. You see here double limit property, but it is equivalent after pointwise closure that F is some compact pointwise compact subset here, C of X, pointwise compact. Such that F separates points of it. And this characterization is very well known for topological spaces and for Eberlein spaces. At least many times I don't know what's the exact source, but Arkhangelsky proves it. Also, Vulko and Namioka and several papers, Edgar Wheeler, I saw that this is a kind, I don't know, maybe it's folklore result or maybe it's of Arkhangelsky, I am not sure. But it is a quite well-known result that it, this F separates points of it. So what we have here? Again, we have, anytime, we have a bounded, of course.
Misha.
Yeah.
So what is it? P?
Pointwise.
Pointwise.
Yeah. So we have here very interesting moment. Two processes, in some sense, antagonistic to each other. First of all, we know that every compact space is dichonal, so we have a class of continuous functions which separate the points, okay, by dichonals. But we need to choose this family small in some smart way. That's the game. So you understand. So we can, of course, always contain take some F, say even bounded, no problem for every compact space which separates the points. But you need small family which separates your X. So first of all, again, what's the two sides here? In order to separate points intuitively, you need large family. Okay, it depends on X, but you need large family. But if you are lucky, or in other words, if your compact space is small, good properties, then you can find this family small. That's the kind of ideas behind this hierarchy. The second case, the case of Eberlein, X is Radu-Nikodym, dependent on if Again, you can find points separated from the family, which is bounded, separating, or X separating, such that F is fragmented. Again, the kind of smallness of your family. Now, this characterization in this formulation is new, so formally it's new, but after some reformulations, you can find some version of this result in Namioka's theory, 82. But the third result, if you take its WRN, this case, if and only if, again, if you find some bounded, everything the same, just take here, eventually, fragment. C of X is separating, the same game. You try to separate points, so you need large family, but you try to do it some economic way. Okay? And separating family such that F is eventually fragmented, and there are several other possibilities to formulate it after we faced the characterization of Rosenthal space. Like, you can say even F is a Rosenthal family, remembering that all the equivalences. So, meaning that if you take pointwise closure is a part of fragmented family. So, let's say, so this part means seems to be interesting. And I think it is a very interesting class to investigate. Now about the table, you see here, so putting together all the results, we see a very nice classification. We have here, we start with some compact metrizable case, the main class of dynamical system theory. And closure will mean pointwise closure. So what we have here in the table, Banach representations, reflexive representations, as we close it up, what kind of condition captures the relation between these concepts? For enveloping semigroups, or in terms of enveloping semigroup, the key idea is a condition is that every element is continuous. Okay? That's the Elis-Nerukka theorem. And it is equivalent that up to Grothendieck's result, the closure of every orbit, pointwise closure of every orbit is a subset. It remains into C of X. For Asplund case, EX is metrizable. I mentioned result joint with Lazar and Uspensky. And we can reformulate it from metrizable case that the pointwise closure is metrizable. And it's just here, the first line, of course, Diplomus-Benedict, second line, HNS. For Rosenthal case, we have every element is bare one. It's just a reformulation of being fragmented for, you know, compact metrizable case I mentioned. And on topological level, if you take pointwise closure of your orbit, if it is, okay, it's not always metrizable, but at least if you found that it is at least Frechet, it is also good, right? So it turns out the Frechet pointwise closure of this orbit, if it's, they are Frechet orb, this is just a case of tameness. And by the way, from metrizable compact spaces, enveloping semigroup is equivalent. The enveloping semigroup, the whole enveloping semigroup, is Frechet. Now about some exams. Okay, let's keep exams. I already explained yesterday. Maybe this part again, third part. Now we know or we have some idea what is a tame, the dynamical system, what is a tame function, And just some final answer about our case of particular case Fibonacci. If you take, for example, some very concrete situation, take some circle T. And divide it into two parts. Well, choose just one subset. You can choose some subset, but we need some concrete. Okay, interval. You can take in this way, for example. Say P 0 this part. I mean, you can P 0 is 0, right? Starts from 0. Yeah. So if you look at T as this interval, as I said, losing simplicity, so if you can consider P at P0 or some C and the rest. Consider the game I already explained yesterday. This is one of the games in symbolic dynamics. So, the picture was, here picture is not so good because you know it's only one dimensional. That's why I repeat the idea. If you take some part of something, some x, you have some dynamical system, say, but we need here some cascade, some iteration of something. So we have some sigma in our dynamical system X. Then you choose Z somewhere and try to understand what happens with the orbit under iterations. And in this way, you get some start from natural numbers, for example, a positive direction, you have some sequence, okay? Some sequence 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, and so on. You get the idea, of course. So, in this way, you have some signal machine. The question was, how complicated is this signal? And in order to understand it, I started my lectures in this a case of some Sturmian sequence, cutting sequence, if you remember. Cutting sequence is another process, another canonical way to get some signal machine. Okay? So we can see that these two concepts meet sometimes. Moreover, it's a very good idea in symbolic dynamics to find some possibility to associate your original sequence to some dynamical systems, looking for some good dynamical systems which can produce you in this way the binary sequences or binary coding. And in our case, what's our case? So I gave a case of a particular case of Fibonacci sequence, but already if you take any irrational slope, okay, any irrational slope, then maybe put see again, here, the Fibonacci sequence is here. So if you get any, in fact, any irrational slope, and you immediately get also the corresponding sequence. And it turns out that in all such cases, we have the same answer. It's a quite well-known class of signals in symbolic dynamics, called Sturmian coding. But it was unknown, it was not a part of classical investigation, it is tame or not. I mean, it's tameness and aspenness and so on is quite new